Hi students, welcome to the channel. In this video lecture, we will discuss SAAS introduction, its benefits, issues and some characteristics. First of all, you should know the full form of SAAS. It stands for Software as a Service. Right, as its name implies, with the help of SAAS, any user can get any type of software according to their requirement, right? All these softwares applications are provided to end users, and also it refers to a software that is deployed on host service and accessible with the help of internet, right? As we have discussed earlier, cloud services are only accessed with the help of internet connection. You should have a good internet connection, only then you can access any type of service provided by cloud service providers, right? Other than this, we have some applications of SAAS. The first application is billing and invoicing system. For example, if I have some accounts department and I want to bill or invoice something and I don't have any particular software of that kind, right? So with the help of SAAS service provider, we can get that kind of software and easily I can handle billing and invoicing. The second point we have is CRM application. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management, right? Next point we have is HRS, that means Human Resource Solutions. All these are done with the help of SAAS, right? Some of the SAAS applications that are not customizable. Non-customizable applications are MS Suite. I think we all are familiar with this MS Suite, right? These are not customizable. That means the end user cannot allowed to change any kind of setting. Any setting like theme, etc. Right? These are called non-customizable applications. But SAAS also provides some customizable applications. It also provides some customizable applications like API. API stands for Application Programming Interface. Application Programming Interface. Such type of applications allow us to change the setting, theme, etc. according to the user's requirement. Application Programming Interface means end user can change the interface of any application according to their need, right? SAAS has some benefits like scalability, efficiency and its performance, right? Other than all these, the major advantages of using SAAS include: the first one is modest software tools. This is a general term that means the SAAS application deployment requires little or no client-side software installation. Right, as we have discussed earlier, with the help of SAAS, we can get any type of software. There is no need to install that software. There is no need to buy that software. Okay, we can get any type of software according to our requirement on a rent basis. Rent basis means pay per use. As we all know, cloud computing services are only on the basis of pay per use. That means we only have to pay that much amount only, right? For example, if I use any software only for 3 hours, I don't have to buy, I don't want to buy that software. I just want to use it only for 3 hours. So I will pay only that much amount, right? So this is taken under modest software tools. The next point we have is efficient use of software licenses, right? This is the second advantage. It means that the customer have single license for multiple computers running at a different location, at different locations, right? So with the help of this, it reduces the licensing cost. And also there is no requirement for license servers because the software runs in the provider's infrastructure, right? This is provided by SaaS. The third advantage we have is centralized management and data. As we all know, in case of cloud computing, the data is stored in a central device. Suppose this is a cloud, it provides some software services, and all these are the end users who want to access the services provided by cloud. Here the cloud providers store data centrally. The main focus to save data centrally is to save its redundancy and reliability. If we want to save the reliability and redundancy of any software, we have to save that data in a centralized manner, right? The fourth advantage is platform responsibilities managed by providers, right? As we all know, all the responsibilities such as backup, system maintenance, security, hardware refresh, power management, and so many other services are performed by the cloud providers. All the customers does not need to bother about them, right? This is the responsibility of SaaS service providers. Next advantage we have is multi-tenant solutions. Multi-tenant solution allow multiple users to share single instance of different resources in virtual isolation, right? Multi-tenant solutions. Here customer can customize their applications without affecting its core functionalities, right? So all these are the advantages of using SaaS. Now we will discuss some issues related to SaaS, right? The first issue we have is browser-based risks. We all know the meaning of browsers. I will explain this with the help of example. That is, if a customer visits some malicious website and browser become infected. If the browser become infected, then the subsequent access to other SaaS applications must compromise the customer data, right? So to avoid such risk, the customer can use multiple browsers. To avoid this, we should use multiple browsers and dedicate a specific browser to access SaaS application. And also we can also use virtual desktop while accessing SaaS applications, right? The next issue we have is it is network dependence. It is network dependence. The SaaS application can be delivered only when a network is continuously available. Network is available, only then we can use SaaS services, right? Also, network should be reliable, but the network reliability cannot be guaranteed either by cloud provider. No guarantee is provided by the service providers, right? So these are the issues at SaaS service providers, right? Now we will discuss some characteristics. As we all know, SaaS means software as a service. It is used to provide some software available over the internet, right? I have told you earlier that internet connection is a must. The second characteristic we have is that the software applications are maintained by all the applications are maintained by vendors. Vendors here means the software service providers, right? All the softwares are maintained by service providers. Third characteristic we have is license. The license to the software may be subscription based or usage based. Usage based, that means pay per use mode is always there. Right, next we have is fourth characteristic that they are available on demand. The same characteristic we have discussed in cloud computing, right? All the cloud computing services are available on users' demand. Fifth characteristic is they are automatically upgraded and updated. This is also the responsibility of vendor or service provider to update or upgrade the software or any type of service. The next characteristic we have is all users run the same version of software, right? This is a simple term. So all these are the characteristics of SaaS services. So this is all about SaaS. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching this.